Hello everyone, welcome to Insecta channel. So today we'll discuss about the insect pest of oilseed crop. So we all know what are the oilseed crop, like castor, mustard, sunflower, groundnut, etc. Okay, so today we'll discuss that insect pest of mustard. Most important pest is mustard aphid, mustard sawfly. So first we'll discuss about the mustard aphid. Okay, so if you are preparing for the JRF, then you have to remember the scientific name, because sometime question may come like what is the scientific name of mustard aphid. So Lipaphis ericinae is the scientific name of mustard aphid. Family is Aphididae, order is Hemiptera. So about the character of the, like body character or adult or nymphal character, everything we have discussed in the cotton, under the group of sucking pest of cotton. So today I'll not discuss about this thing. So directly we'll see the damage symptom. Okay, so first, both the nymph and adult, they will suck the sap from the leaf, bud and pod of the mustard. Okay, then as a result, what will happen? Curling of the leaf will happen, and what will further symptoms are like withering and dying. Okay, all the body of the mustard plant will die. Okay, then plant will remain stunted, that means growth will not occur, and sooty mold will grow, because this mustard aphid, they will release the honeydew, and on the honeydew the sooty mold will grow. Okay, so next is the field will look like sickly and blighted in appearance. So sickly appearance of the field will occur. Next we'll see the management, how we will manage this. We have to use the tolerant varieties, then we can clip the infested twigs of the mustard leaf. Then you have to sow the crop before 20th October, then you can set the yellow sticky trap, then we can release the ladybird beetle, then cirrhid fly or braconid parasitoid or lacewing bugs. Okay, so also you can release the verticillium lecani, and you can spray the following insecticide in the flowering stage, like oxidamentin, methyl oxidamentin, dimethoid, these you can spray. Then mustard sawfly, the scientific name is Otalia lugens proxima. Then the family is Tenthredinidae, and order is Hymenoptera. Okay, so this pest also, it will attack to the radish and crucifer. Okay, then appearance, the larva, it will look like greenish black with wrinkled body. So this is the greenish black, and body is wrinkled, little bit wrinkled. Okay, then they are having 8 pairs of prolegs. This is most important question. Even in NET exam also, you may get this question, as well as in JRF also, you may get this question. Like 8 pair of prolegs, or mustard sawfly larva are having dash pair of prolegs. Okay, so remember 16 prolegs, and that is in 8 pairs. Okay, then the larva is having fange death, like if you will touch them, they will act like they died and they will fall on the ground, but actually they will not die, that is known as fange death. Okay, then adult, head and thorax is black in color, as you can see, head and thorax black in color. Then abdomen is orange in color, so starting this abdomen portion, it is orange in color, and wings, you can see, it is black in color. Okay, smoky black color wings are there. Then these are the life cycle. So the total life cycle of the sawfly is 31 to 34 days, nearly 1 month. Okay, and they will, where they will lay egg, I already told, you have to remember where they are laying the eggs, where they are pupating, these things are important, rather than the number of pupal days, nymphal days, these things you cannot remember for all the insect. Just remember where they are laying the eggs. So mustard sawfly, they will lay the egg singly near the leaf margin. Okay, so now we'll discuss the damage symptom. So first, what will happen, they will nibble the leaves, they will start making hole on the leaves, from the, they will start feeding from the margin towards the midrib, they will come, this is the midrib portion, towards this they will come, and they will entirely defoliate this leaf. Okay, so defoliation in mustard is caused by the Athalia lugens, that is mustard sawfly. Okay, then they will also completely, they will feed on the shoot portion, and in seedling stage if they are attacking, then the seedling will die. And suppose if they are attacking in the reproductive stage, then what will happen? The plant cannot bear the seeds, okay? They cannot form the pod, okay? So this is the damage symptom of mustard sawfly. So how you will manage this? You can summer ply to destroy the pupa, because this mustard sawfly, they will pupate inside the soil. Where they will lay the eggs? Near the leaf margin, okay? Early sowing you can do, you can maintain the clean cultivation, then you can collect and destroy the grub of the sawfly in the morning and evening hours. Then you can conserve some parasitoid and the grub. Then also you can use this Bacterium serratia. Then you can use bitter gourd seed oil as a antifidant, okay? So you can use this bitter gourd seed oil on the plant. You can spray the malathion or quinalfos. Then you can also apply this in 600 to 700 liter of water per hectare, okay? You can mix this in 600 to 700 liter of water, then you can spray on the plant. Then we'll see the painted bug. This is also a pest of mustard. So painted bug, the scientific name is Bagarda hilaris, belongs to the family Pentatomidae, order is Hemiptera. So these bugs are oval in shape, pale yellow egg, and the eggs they will lay singly, okay? Where they will lay the egg? On leaf, then stalk, then pod, sometimes in the soil also they will lay the egg, okay? So full grown nymphs are black in color. When they will become adult, you can see this is the adult. So the adult color will be orange and black spot will be there, okay? Body color will be black, and you will find some orange color is mixed with it, okay? Then the life cycle, total life cycle is 19 to 54 days, okay? Then damage symptom, how they will cause the damage symptom? Both the nymphs and adults, they will suck the sap, okay? So both the nymphs and adults, they will suck the sap from the leaves, developing pod. And what will happen? They are sucking means gradually the plant will dry. Wilting, drying, this thing will occur if they are sucking, okay? Nymphs and adults are also excrete a sort of resinous material, okay? So on the pod, suppose this is the mustard pod, so on the pod they will excrete some resinous material, okay? So this resinous material, they will spoil the pod. How you will manage this painted bug? Deep plowing you can do to destroy the eggs, because they will also lay the egg in the soil. Apart from the leaf stem, also they will lay the egg in the soil. Then early sowing you can do. Then you can irrigate the crop during the pest attack. Then whenever you are harvesting, so soon after harvesting you have to do threshing. Then you can burn all the remaining residue left in the mustard field, okay? Then the bugs, usually they congregate on the leaf stem, which can be jerked to dislodge them. So you just wo ped ko thoda jerking karke, you can make the bugs to fall down on the kerosinized water. Niche kerosene ka pani rakhna hai, fir usko plant ko thoda jerk karo, so that jo bug rehta hai wo niche girke kerosinized pani mein uske andar chala jayega, fir wo mar jayega, okay? You can control the, like you can conserve the biocontrol agent such as Allophora species. You can spray malathion or dimethoate, okay? Any one control measure you can follow. In combination you can follow, okay? Then leaf waver. So leaf waver, in early stage you will find these insects are attacking to the plant, okay? So leaf waver, the scientific name is Crocidolomia binotalis, okay? So it belongs to the family Pyrostidae and order is Lepidoptera. So their larva is pale yellowish to brown in color, with a series of lateral and sublateral black spot and specks. So suppose this is the larva. So you will find a series of black spot on their body. And the color is pale yellow, sometime brown also you will find. Okay, pale yellow to brown. Then adult moth are yellowish brown. You can see this is the adult moth. Four wings have reddish brown distinct and wavy lines. So distinct reddish brown in color with wavy markings on the four wings you will find. And also you will find the prominent white spot on the wings. Okay. And near to the thoracic region, you will find a black tuft of hairs are there in this thoracic. Suppose this is the head, this is the thoracic region. Here you will find the tufts of hairs are there. Then what is the damage symptom? So newly hatched larva, they will feed initially to the chlorophyll of young leaves. Okay. And later they will feed on the older leaf, then bud, then also the pod. So they will web together all these things. Okay. That's why they are known as leaf weber. So they will web the leaves and they will live within it and they will feed inside. Okay. Severe, whenever you will find they are severely attacking, then the defoliation of the plant will occur. So defoliation already caused by the sawfly. So here also in severe attack, the leaf weber will also cause the defoliation. And seeds inside the pod will also be eaten by this leaf weber. How you will manage? You can spray the insecticide such as Fosalan at the rate 2 ml per liter, or Fenvalerate you can spray 20 EC, that is 0.5 ml per liter, or also you can use Imamectin benzoate 2 ml per liter. Okay. So insect pest of castor, this we will discuss in the next part. Thank you all.